Welcome back on Denmo. Today I want to propose you the review about the new FAQ released for the Flesh Eater course by the Games Workshop for the second edition of Age of Sigma in the date of the 27th of June of the 2018. The first rat that we talk is about hints and tips, and it's about returning slain models. This is quite interesting returning models. In fact, you have to add the models to the unit that you came back in the way that you can only came back the models within 1 inch from the models that are yet on the unit. So you can't use as a bridge to make improve the different models. So in the way that you, for example, regain three models, you can't make the three models all together to improve the range of the unit itself. You can only improve in the way that you can use the models that are yet in the unit in the way that you can put them in the range. But anyway, remember that they apply also in the way that if you apply the returning models more than once, you can then using such a thing in the way that you can first put the models within 1 inch. When you do again, you use the previous model too for the regaining back the models. So it's quite interesting because it lets you know how to do such a thing. Another thing that it said is that you can't position the new models within 3 inch of an enemy, so bring the enemy in close combat, unless you have yet models of that unit that are in close combat, so within 3 inch of the enemy unit. So it's really quite interesting one as a thing, because it's one of the best way to understand how to position the model that you had back of the returning slain model. So it's really quite interesting one. And now I treat free errata together, because they treat the same thing, and it's about the ability, command abilities that has been changed as functioning during this new edition. And these command abilities are referring to the Aberrant Gold Keen on Tarogeist, the Aberrant Gold Keen on Zombie Dragons, and the Aberrant Gold Keen themselves. And it's quite interesting because now it specified that these command abilities are going to be used at the end of your movement phase, and the units that you summon to new ones to the field are to be wholly within 6 inch instead of before being within 3 inch. So you lose the option that you have the base over the 3 inch, because they needed only the contact. But being wholly within 6 inch, it means also that anyway the range that they have to be deployed, it's bigger than before. So anyway, it's a good thing. And it's quite interesting because these abilities are really good. I want to remember you that for the new rules, you don't have to pay now the points for the models that you summoned with such command abilities. So it means that you have new units that you can deploy on the field. So they are really quite interesting ones to apply. And I suggest you to really take note about these ones. So for this command abilities, I made a single talking about them, but they are really quite interesting ones. And now again, I put together different errata, and they are the errata about the To the King of the Wargrove Courtier ability, the Master Man at Arms of the Cryptghast Courtier, the Master King's Chosen of the Crypt Hunter Courtier, and the Master Royal Guard of the Crypt Infernal Courtier. These are rephrasing of the previous abilities, are simply rephrasing, so the ability it doesn't change. It's simply in the way that you have a better understanding of the functioning of such ability, but anyway, it's nothing special. Anyway, you have to take note only to understand that it changed in the form, but the effect it's exactly the same, so nothing particular to note about. The next one has a rat that has been about this Battletome. It's related to the Tarogeist and Zombie Dragon in this Battletome as names for the unit that has been changed in the Flesh Eater Course Tarogeist and Flesh Eater Curse Dragon as names, so that you can have a referring about. So you have to take note about this change in the way that you can then refer to the General Handbook 2018 as the points for using such models. And now we can see the changes about the abilities of the different Vorskull battalions in this battletome. And the first that we can see is Summon Sycophant from the Vorskull Battalion Royal Family. This has a great change of the ability itself, because before it had the limitation only to have 6 Aberrant Gold King on the field. Now it's only once per battle that you can use such command ability up to the end of your Mundra phase, and only if your general is from this battalion and is on the field. So you have to pay great attention to usage this ability itself. Moreover, it's summoned different because the range that you can have from the edge that you can deploy such a model, it's a 6 inch instead of before a 3 inch, so it's a good thing in that case. Anyway, it had a great difference because it changed quite a lot the usage of such ability compared to before, because before you had the option to have a lot more of Abhorrent Gold Kings on the field. Now you can only add one. So it's a great change about using such ability of this Vorskull Battalion. The next ability that has been changed is the one that is steward to the king of the Vorskull Battalion Attendants at Court. And it's related to the using of the abilities, the command abilities, because it hasn't been changed the way to use the command abilities themselves. Now with this errata, it lets you have one additional command point if your general is within 10 inch of the Crypt Hunter courtier from this battalion. So it's a really quite interesting one as option. And the next of the abilities that have been changed, it's the one that it's Dark Master of the Vorskull Battalion Flesh Eater Court. And it's quite a big change, but you have to remember that the command abilities has changed in the way to be used. And it's quite important because it reduces the options that this ability brings, because before it would have been let you use 3 different command abilities each turn. Now it lets you add, at the start of the battle, 3 command points from every this battalion instead of 1. So it's a great change, because before it was 3, now it's 3 but once. So it's this change that it's important. Anyway, you almost never will be able to use such ability, because this Vorskull Battalion include all the other Vorskull Battalion of the Flesh Eater Court. So it will be quite difficult to be able to play such Vorskull Battalion itself. But if you are able to play it, remember that you have such change in this ability. The last errata is about the usage of the last pages of this battle tome, and it's referring to the rules. Because these rules were about the previous rules of Age of Sigmar, you have to remember that the edition has changed, so these rules are not more available, has been changed. So remember only that they are not more to be used, so they are outed. And so it remember you such a thing, simply it. I want to include here also an extra part, and it's about the base dimensions that has been updated. And I think that the one that will be changed with the next series of FAQ, it will be the base about the Aberrant Gold King, because it can be possible that it's a 25 mm one. Moreover, if you consider that in the box of the Flesh Eater Court itself, it has been used a 32 mm one, and all the other of the heroes that are on foot of the death are on 32 mm base. So I don't understand, and I think that it's a mistake that this model it instead has a 25 mm one as base. So it's an adding to the FAQ that I think that will be released in the next session, because it's something that it's not suitable. So these are the changing for the battle tome of the Flesh Eater Court. Sincerely, they are changing, that I was expecting to be, because they were the ones that could be quite problematic about the usage of the ones. So even if I don't understand some rephrasing that I talked about before, the change about the commandability related ones I completely understand, because they were needed. So it's a good thing that they have been done. So, from Dynamod it's everything. I invite you to put a like on this video, to subscribe to the channel, to ring the bell, and to comment this video if you are interested in something about this video or you want to suggest me some arguments for other videos. I hope to see you again to the next time.